Looking ahead to some of the guys who could break out this year. This guy, not light. He is built like a rock, right? That was the MO on him coming out of the draft, was he was NHL ready as far as that body goes. And he proved it his rookie season in Carolina. All 82 games locked. Look at the stats, 37 points. He did miss the last six playoff games with a concussion, and the Canes certainly missed him in the absence. What do you think Andrei Svechnikov is capable of now that he has a year under his belt?
I think, first of all, he proved that he's the player we thought he was, that we saw in junior hockey, that he's just a pure goal scorer. If you watch some of the goals he scored last year, some of the power moves he made, his ability to get to the net, hold off defenders, use that big frame. He's got great edges. He shoots well. He's a guy that, for me, will clearly get to the 35-goal mark, maybe double that 20-goal mark one day. I'm looking for that big jump up to come next year, though, because I felt like last year was really just wetting his feet, a toe in the water at the most. The sky is the limit for him. And if he plays with Sebastian Aho and Niederreiter
again. Kind of taking Justin Williams' spot right now until he decides to come back.
Exactly. And a lot of the players we're highlighting today are guys that have some type of opportunity. We know Justin Williams. He might be back at some point. He may never be back. We don't know that for certain. We believe he will. But in the interim, a guy like Svechnikov that has the type of skills that he does, he is primed and ready to roll.
And a lot of these guys, again, it's making the most of the opportunity presented to you. We talked Borgstrom. Let's talk Bjorkstrand this time. How about Oliver Bjorkstrand? You see his numbers? 77 games with Columbus, and Columbus coming off their most successful season in franchise history. How does the team and how do Borgstrom kind of keep that stride going in the right direction?
Well, obviously, Panarin's gone. Duchesne is gone. Dzingel is gone. Same theme. Going to be a lot of opportunity. The biggest thing that's going to change for Oliver is that 12-plus minutes that he got last year that he averaged, I could see that easily up 4.5, 5 minutes. That's a huge jump for a guy that's been a natural goal scorer, the Great Dane, all his life. He did it in Portland with the Winterhawks, scored 63 goals in 59 games in that league. It's now finally starting to translate into the National Hockey League. If Wennberg can have any type of season and those two play together, he's going to be a dominant force. He's a guy that will easily crack that 25-goal mark, and I would not be surprised to see him hit the 30-goal mark next year for the Columbus Blue Jackets.
8 goals in his final 8 regular season games for Columbus, so certainly capable of putting up those numbers. His teammate, Artemi Panarin, left for greener pastures in New York. This guy was already there, Philip Hedl, coming off a good campaign, 75 games, 23 points, expectations for this former first-rounder, top 10 pick. They're high. What do you think he can do coming up next year?
You know what? Last year was obviously a transition year for the New York Rangers, and it was a great opportunity for a lot of guys to pick up minutes. This big Czech player, and I say big, not lightly, he's about 210 pounds. He's got the body to withstand this league. I know he's only 20, but I think he's the guy that's on the cusp of exploding. He got a taste of what it's like to play in one of the greatest arenas in the world, Madison Square Garden, last year. If he can somehow put together a full season, going to have to maybe rely on another rookie in Kravtsov. The sky is the limit for him. I see him easily getting to the 40-point mark this year with a chance to crest 50, a chance to hit 25 goals. All the skills are there. All the talent is there. He's got to reach out and grab it.
All right. We'll see how it plays out in New York. Meanwhile, fans in Philly are hoping for another breakout performance by this guy. Broke onto the scene and took them right down the stretch and clearly took over that number one starting role in the process. Carter Hart coming around. Only played 31 games, but in those 31 games, he did great. What do you think? Expectations now that we're going to have a much larger sample size for this young kid.
Yeah, he's got the pedigree to come in and be a starter in this league. Nobody thought it would be quite this quickly, though. I thought he'd get a taste last year. I thought he'd play well in stretches, but the club wasn't necessarily elite. A couple of factors going on this year. Number one, he's got some experience. He's been the guy for 31 games, as you said, and he really was sensational. Number two, I think the Flyers are going to surprise a lot of teams this year. They traded for Matt Niskanen. Provorov is a guy that you can count on. That decor is going to be stronger. Alain Vigneault is a very veteran coach in this league. He's going to roll 4 lines, structure, playing hard defensively. I expect all that to elevate. I expect Carter Hart to benefit from that and prove and he can move up into that starters category. You got to play at least 41 games in arbitration to be tabbed as a starter. I think he easily does it this year. I think he has a continuation of last year.
When you think of Carter Hart, who does he compare to? What style? Is he a Carey Price kind? Is he a Marc-Andre Fleury kind? Well, how do you categorize this kid?
I would take styles from different people, but the one thing that he does do that reminds me of another goaltender is very calm and very cool. Very much like Carey Price, a guy that's unflappable, almost an assassin back there. He's economical in his movements, doesn't necessarily make all the saves that look like they're all world, but he makes everything look so easy. And that's what I see when I watch Carter Hart. He's in the right places. He's poised. He's confident. He's not flopping all over the place.